Horsey people, this is going to be another part of those dentist things, because if you watch the Equine Dentistry series that I did with Dr. Warren, he went over pictures kind of quickly, and I couldn't get really good shots after looking at those videos. So if you watch those videos, I wanted to show you on the site. You could go on my site to look at it, and I'll show you on his site also. But if you just go to my thinklikeahorse.org, and then over here on the left, you'll see horse anatomy pictures. And if you click on that, it's going to take you to this page here, where I've got all kind of pages of different parts of the horse, labeling a horse. I mean, just all kind of photos that I think are interesting to help people understand horses better. There's some markings on how to on different things that they call horses on markings. Again, a lot of different pictures. So if you keep scrolling down, all these pictures, I go over muscle, bones, etc. Let's see here. The digestive system, I mean, all the 27, 75 feet of intestines in the horse. So after going through all these pictures, you're going to get down here, and it's going to get you to, I think it's coming up here. Well, it is coming up. All right, there's the hoof. This is a great picture of the hoof. I'm always talking about hoof. I know we're talking about dental here, but this hoof picture, I just love this. Shows how the hoof actually flexes when it doesn't have a shoe on. So the part in the middle is the frog there. You see it pumping. It's allowed to get. You see how the hoof kind of spreads out. I think I have another moving picture in here on a hoof that's pretty good, that shows a different way a hoof moves. These three show the hoof. So the hoof stretches out, it stretches down, it expands and contracts. Again, why I'm not a fan of shoes, why shoes stop all this. None of this can happen with a horse with a shoe on. But anyway, we're on dental stuff. I know I get distracted. So I go over the hoof, go over different bones. I mean, talk about the skin, the muscle, the tendons, the eye, how the horse eye is. And then we get, well, that's the heart. There's a real heart. Here we go. And we get to the head and teeth. So a lot of things that he was talking about in the teeth video, when I went back here and kind of, after he explains a few things, I kind of went back to make sure my page had accurate information or good information or something they didn't tell me. And if you notice right here, you notice these teeth are nice and flat. And that's what he was talking about. Those teeth will move back and forth pretty nicely. And he showed you on Mr. T real quick, but I just kind of wanted to get a good picture in there on that. And then again, of course, the molars here, some label the front three the premolars, then it's, but there's basically six molars up and top on here. And then the wolf teeth he showed you when he pulled one out. And then the two canines that he followed down. And then your incisor up front. So these are your incisors. So if you watch the videos, all that's going to sound familiar. Telling the age of a horse by their teeth. If you notice on the one-year-old here, the teeth are almost up and down straight. And then as you move to the 21-year-old, they start pointing forward. And that's kind of where you look at a horse's teeth to see how old he is. And the old saying, don't ever look a gift horse in the mouth, came from if somebody gave you a horse in the old days, it was considered impolite to look in their mouth and check their teeth to see how old they were. Because if somebody was giving you a horse and you checked the teeth, it was almost like you were trying to check the price tag on a gift. Although I don't think I'd give them a gift, but you know, if somebody gave you an old plow horse or something, it was impolite to check the teeth to see how old. The other old phrase that deals with teeth, he's a little long in the tooth. As the horses get older, they get longer. So older horses have longer teeth, hence the phrase, that person or that horse a little old, long in the tooth, meaning he's got some age on him. So, and again, this is another age photo here. And if you want to go again to the site and do that and look at it yourself, you can do that. I thought this was a good picture. It showed the hooks and the ramps that he was talking about, these little bitty red hooks. And again, this will cause the horse to overbite. If this hook right here comes down, it's not going to let the teeth level. Or if this hook in the back of here hooks that forward. So those are basically the tips and points that he was talking about filing down. Let's see what else we got here. That's just another one. It goes over the premolars, the upper canines, lower, the tooth. You notice how long the root is? He told me how long the root is, and I can't remember, so I don't want to give the wrong information. But it was pretty amazing on how long the root is to a horse's teeth. And I think he said the root gets shorter or longer as a horse gets older. I'm not sure. And then this goes into the horse about young and old. You notice on a young horse, the teeth are kind of straight up and down. And on here, they're going to be pushing forward so you see more. And that's basically on those incisors. This is a pretty good picture that shows the molars, the bars, those little bitty wolf teeth there, and then the two canines or the three canines there. The incisors point out. See, look at this horse teeth. He looks a little old. See, he's kind of a little long in the tooth there. So he looks a little older on this video. And then here's another one that if you want to study the teacher's horse or the horse's teeth and figure out how to tell their age. Again, when they're old, it goes forward. When they're new, they're more up and down, more vertical versus reaching out laterally. And then he was talking about filing down the canine teeth. And these are the canines that you're filing down. And this is how, you know, he said he usually files those down. So, one, they don't bite their tongue. And then when a bit goes through there, it doesn't hit it. And if you don't use a bit, you don't have to worry about that. But for them not biting their tongue, this is a great picture that shows if their canines get too long, how they can bite their own tongue. And then he also went over the numbering system. And if you look at this photo, this kind of goes over his numbering system that he was talking about. Left side, right side, uppers and lowers, the 100, 200, 300. And again, and then I found this picture on his site, so I just added it, which I thought was pretty cool. Is these are the canines of a before and picture, a before and after picture of the canine. So this is the canine that was overgrown that could have bit his tongue, and this is what he did after he filed it down on the top and bottom there. So this is a great picture, and he's got some more good pictures on his site. I'm going to go to his site right after I'm finished this. This picture shows what's called an overbite, where the teeth are overbite, and you can tell the top teeth are more forward, and the back teeth are back. This is called a wave mouth, where the teeth wear in this wave. He said, you know, Buddy and Mr. T's teeth were pretty straight. This is a step mouth. I'm not sure what a step mouth means. Looks like there's a little step right there, maybe. And then this is a normal bite to where they're kind of straight. And I know I'm going fast, but you can see it. These are shows how long the roots are, how high they are. And that might be it. Yeah, then I get into the horse's head, the nerves, different muscles, the brain, how big the brain is, kind of what the ears look like. Anyway, this is the horse anatomy picture. So if you want to visit the site, I go into how a horse sees, his vertical, monocular, binocular vision. That's a horse fetus that was aborted. Oh, sorry, I got to give a warning. Don't panic, there's a bad picture there that's going to scare you. Let's see, medical and vital signs on a horse. I have that written down. So, you know, you can kind of tell what's normal. And this may not be your horse, but it's nice to know what normal is. Then if you go do your horse routinely, you know what's normal for your horse. Therefore, when your horse is having issues, you know what's abnormal. And this is where a guy wrote an article on how big the brain is. So anyway, that is the horse anatomy pictures. And, oh, wait a minute. I was going to go to his site. Shit, darn it. I'm going to give him a plug here for letting me videotape and everything. So if you go to his site, and I've got his link in all the videos, and I'll put his link in here, he shows different pictures. See how this tooth right here is hanging over? So this horse, the top mouth, can't move left and right easy, so they can't chew sideways. So by making that flat and making these flat, that would make the mouth, you know, rub like this. Versus if it's long, it won't go past it if this is long. But if they're level, then they can, when they can chew like this. So, let's see here. He had a couple other good pictures on here. This was a good picture of showing the different teeth. And again, these are all on his website. So, you know, feel free to go there. And it's got his email and contact information. That's a good picture of a point. that little hook right there, or point, would not allow him to be flat and smooth. So by filing that off, then the horse could chew sideways. I didn't even know these pictures were here until I started searching, and I found that one picture, and then I went to this page. Because I went to a site, but I didn't see all these pictures. And then he shows an ulcer here. He shows all these tips and points right here that you take off. Really good picture. So if you watched the video and you saw what he did to Mr. T and Buddy, you can go to his website and look at his teeth. That's the picture I just added to mine. If he wants me to take it down, I will. It's got his little name on it, so I don't think he'll mind. But if he does, he'll let me know. He knows how to get in touch with me. And then this is a picture where a horse has retained his baby teeth, so they're kind of still in there. This is the ridges before. You see all those points and tips, kind of like you did on Buddy and Mr. T. And then after it's done, they're all smooth and gone away. That's going to aid in the chewing. Nice sight there, Doc. That's another picture of, hell, I don't know, before and after the points. Anyway, hopefully that'll help. This will be a good little addition to the Equine Dentist series, so you learn more about the horse's teeth. You know what to look for in case you want to get up in your horse's mouth and take a look. All right, we'll end that there.